Throughout the Bible, ashes, like fasting, have always been a sign of repentance. In the book of Job, we read that Job says, "I retract, I repent in dust and ashes." The prophet Daniel says, "I gave my attention to the Lord to seek him by prayer with supplication, with fasting, sackcloth, and ashes." And the prophet Jeremiah, speaking to the people of Jerusalem, said, "O daughter of my people, put on sackcloth and roll in ashes." In the book of Jonah, chapter 3, verse 6, we read that the king of Nineveh rose from his throne, covered himself with sackcloth, and sat in ashes. Jesus himself, in Luke chapter 10, verse 13, speaking to the people of Capernaum, he said, "If the mighty works done in you had been done in Tyre and Sidon, they would have repented in sackcloth and ashes." Meanwhile, we read in St. Luke's Gospel that as the time drew near for him to be taken up, he resolutely set his face towards Jerusalem. And he began to make it clear to his disciples that he was destined to go to Jerusalem to suffer and to be put to death. And when Peter began to remonstrate with him, Jesus rebuked him and said, "If anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me." That's Matthew chapter 16, verse 24. The ashes we wear on Ash Wednesday are a sign that we recognize our sinfulness and our need for repentance. Repentance is not a once-off event. It's an ongoing process. It's a work in progress. In this time of Lent, we identify with Jesus, who spent 40 days in the desert in prayer and fasting, and he was tempted. We make a special effort to deny ourselves, especially by fasting, by almsgiving, and by prayer. So we follow Jesus more closely, all the way to Jerusalem, to suffering, to the cross, to the tomb, and to the glory of the resurrection. Thanks be to